I recently came across an unknown person. I was confused who she was. I searched for her all over the internet. But at last, I found her and came to know the truth. I will be revealing that through this video. Hi friends, welcome back to another video from my YouTube channel. It's me, Sean Mithu. In this video, I'll be discussing about a special kind of application which most of you are familiar. That is none other than the Face App. I will be discussing about the most crucial privacy issues concerned with this application. Whether using this app is safe or not, you can decide after watching this video. So stay tuned and watch this video till the end. FaceApp is a photo and video editing application available in Android and iOS. It was developed by Wireless Lab, a company based in Russia, way back in 2017. This application can make realistic transformations of human faces with the help of artificial intelligence. The app can transform a face to make it smile, look younger, look older, or change gender. There are a lot of features available in FaceApp. That is, you can change the entire quality and form of your face. You can change your face impressions, smiles, age, size, apply makeups, give beauty touch-ups, do morphing, etc. These features are all part of fun and entertainment. But apart from all these, there is one particular feature the FaceApp offers. That is, it can change your gender. And this can give way to a lot of cyber crimes and privacy issues. I will be discussing that through this video. In this fast-growing world of technologies and artificial intelligence, it is mandatory to think about this. Talking about the privacy policies regarding this application, every photo you select for editing will be uploaded to the company's servers for image processing and face transformation. And the company tells that all the uploaded photos will be deleted from its servers within 48 hours from the upload data. That, however, stands as a partial truth. The most dangerous part of the Face App, according to my opinion, is the gender swapping technology. This particular feature can enable any males to change himself to a female version and any females to change herself to a male version. In short, this feature helps in the creation of fake identities. Due to this, FaceApp has got a lot of privacy issues. The point which I am taking here is the gender concept, the changing of gender using the FaceApp. Once you change your gender, you can easily manipulate others with your face. You can appear as a male in the place of a female, and you can also appear as a female in the place of a male. This can create a lot of hangovers and unwanted emotions in people. People can prank each other, either seriously or unseriously, by changing his/her gender. This can, however, create mental breakdowns, emotional distress, depressions, etc. in the opposite person receiving the prank. Especially in social medias, people can manipulate their identity with the face application. They can swap and misuse their genders and commit a lot of cybercrimes. For example, if a person swaps his gender into a different male or female and comes before you virtually as a trusted representative of a reputed company or agency, what will you do? So the safest way is to stay away from chatting or interacting with strangers over social medias unless and until you have seen him/her face to face physically in reality. Hello friends, now let me come to the photo of the unknown person I have shown at the beginning of this video. You can just check the side screen next to me. I hope you are remembering this person. This is a fake identity. And the truth is, this fake person is none other than me myself. I have created a fake female version of my face using the Face App. And this is one form of the identity swapping pranks that can take place in the cyberspace using this application. And this is one of the serious issues which you all must be concerned about regarding the face application. And remember, never believe in virtuality, only believe in reality. Because in this fast growing world, virtuality has overtaken reality. Never believe anyone in social medias. I mean, never believe any strangers in social medias. Don't talk with strangers whom you do not know in social medias, because we cannot confirm the identity. Because of the invention of this face app, there are a lot of people making fake identities and getting into social medias. Avoid talking to strangers and virtually believing them, because we cannot confirm their identity, whether they are males or females. Because this face app can make a male into a female and a female into a male version. And the face app might be using the faces of different people around the world for its transformation and effects. And friends, never believe in virtuality, only believe in reality. This is the main message and conclusion I would like to bring about through this video. I hope you enjoyed it. So now I hope this video was entertaining and informative. Feel free to leave your comments and responses below this video. I would love to know them. So we'll meet again next time and end the video with a fresh topic. Till then, bye, take care, stay home, stay safe.